Every who down in Whoville liked Christmas a lot, but the Grinch. Who lived just north of Whoville did not. The Grinch hated Christmas the whole Christmas season. Now, please don't ask why, no one quite knows the reason. It could be his head wasn't screwed on just right. It could be, perhaps, that his shoes were too tight. But I think the most likely reason of all may have been that his heart was two sizes too small. But whatever his reason, his heart or his shoes, he stood there on Christmas Eve, hating the Whos. Staring down from his cave with a sour, grinchy frown at the warm-lighted windows below in the town. For he knew every Who down in Whoville beneath was busy now, hanging a mistletoe wreath. And they're hanging their stockings, he snarled with a sneer. Tomorrow is Christmas! It's practically here! And he growled with his Grinch fingers nervously drumming. I must find some way to keep this Christmas from coming. For tomorrow, he knew, all the Who girls and boys would wake bright and early, they'd rush for their toys, and then, oh, the noise, oh, the noise, noise, noise! That's one thing he hated, the noise, 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 noise! Then the Who's young and old would sit down to a feast, and they'd feast, and they'd feast, and they'd feast, 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 feast! They'd feast on Who pudding and rare Who roast beast, which was a feast that the Grinch couldn't stand in the least. And then they'd do something he liked least of all. Every Who down in Whoville, the tall and the small, would stand close together with Christmas bells ringing. They'd stand hand in hand, and the Whos would start singing. And they'd sing, and they'd sing, 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 sing. And the more the Grinch thought of this Who Christmas sing, the more the Grinch thought, I must stop this whole thing. Why, for 53 years I've put up with it now. I must stop this Christmas from coming. But how? Then he got an idea. An awful idea. The Grinch got a wonderfully awful idea. I know just what to do, the Grinch laughed in his throat. And he made a quick Santa Claus hat and a coat. And he chuckled and clucked, what a great Grinchy trick. With this coat and this hat, I look just like Saint Nick. All I need is a reindeer. And the Grinch looked around, but since reindeer are scarce, there was none to be found. But did that stop the Grinch? No, the Grinch simply said, if I can't find a reindeer, I'll make one instead. So he took his dog Max, and he took some red thread, and he tied a big horn on the top of his head. Then he loaded some bags and some old empty sacks on a ramshackled sleigh, and he hitched up old Max. Then the Grinch said, get up! And the sleigh started down toward the homes where the Whos lay a snooze in that town. All the windows were dark, quiet snow filled the air, and the Whos were all dreaming sweet dreams without care. When he came to the first little house on the square, this is stop number one, the old Grinchy Claus hissed, and he climbed to the roof, empty bags in his fist. Then he slid down the chimney, a rather tight pinch, but if Santa could do it, then so could the Grinch. He got stuck only once for a moment or two, then he stuck his head out of the fireplace flue, where the little Who stockings all hung in a row, The stockings, he grinned, are the first things to go. Then he slithered and slunk with a smile most unpleasant around the whole room, and he took every present. Pop guns and bicycles, roller skates, drums, checkerboards, tricycles, popcorn and plums. Then he stuffed them in bags, then the Grinch very nimbly stuffed all the bags one by one up the chimney. Then he slunk to the icebox. He took the Who's Feast. He took the Who Pudding. He took the Roast Beast. He cleaned out that icebox as quick as a flash. Why, the old Grinch even took the last can of Who Hash. Then he stuffed all the food up the chimney with glee. Ah, now, grinned the Grinch, I will stuff up the tree. And the Grinch grabbed the tree and he started to shove, when he heard a small coo, like a coo of a dove. He turned round fast, and he saw a small Who, little Cindy Lou who was no more than two. The Grinch had been caught by this tiny Who daughter, who got out of bed for a cup of cold water. She stared at the Grinch and said, Santa Claus, why? Why are you taking our Christmas tree? Why? But you know that old Grinch was so smart and so slick. He thought up a lie, and he thought it up quick. Why, my sweet little tot, the fake Santa Claus lied. There's a light on this tree that won't light on one side. So I'm taking it home to my workshop, my dear. I'll fix it up there. I'll bring it back here. And his fib fooled the child, and he patted her head, and he got her a drink and sent her to bed. And when Cindy Lou Who was in bed with her cup, he went to the chimney and stuffed the tree up. And the last thing he took was a log for the fire. Then he went up the chimney himself, the old liar. On their walls he left nothing but hooks and some wire. And the last speck of food that he left in the house was a crumb that was even too small for a mouse. Then he did the same thing to the other Who's houses, leaving crumbs much too small for the other Who's mouses. It was 12:15. All the Who's stood in bed. All the Who's took a snooze when he packed up his sled. Packed it up with their presents, the ribbons, the trappings, the tags and the tinsel, the trimmings, the trappings. 3,000 feet up, up the side of Mount Crumpet. He rode up with his load to the tip top. Hoobah to the Who's, he was grinchously humming. They're finding out now that no Christmas is coming. They're waking up now, I know just what they'll do. Why, their mouths will hang open for a minute or two, and the Who's on in Whoville will all cry boo. Oh, why, that is a sound, grinned the Grinch, that I simply must see. So he paused, and the Grinch put a hand to his ear. And he did hear a sound rising over the snow. It started in low, and it started to grow. But this sound wasn't sad. Why, this sounded merry. It couldn't be so, but it was merry. Very. He stared down at Whoville, the Grinch popped his eyes, and he shook. What he saw was a shocking surprise. Every Who down in Whoville, the tall and the small, was singing, without any presents at all. He hadn't stopped Christmas from coming. It came, somehow or another. It came just the same. And the Grinch, with his Grinch feet ice cold in the snow, stood puzzling and puzzling. How could it be so? Came without ribbons. Came without tags. Came without packages, boxes, or bags. And he puzzled 3 hours till his puzzler was sore. Then the Grinch thought of something he hadn't before. Maybe Christmas, he thought, doesn't come from a store. Perhaps Christmas, perhaps, means a little bit more. And what happened then? Well, Whoville, they say, that the Grinch's small heart grew 3 sizes that day. And the minute his heart didn't feel quite so tight, he whizzed with his load through the bright morning light. He brought back the toys, all the food for the feast. And he himself, the Grinch, carved the roast beast.